Would you please come here? Would you please come?
This is Sagibu. Sandra.
Very nice to visit the primary health center in Dehi, and I am impressed by how organized all of the services are, and impressed by the fact that chronic disease appears to be a real priority here, and that you do a lot to try to prevent the complications of hypertension and diabetes through the health education and through the process of outreach to track down those people who haven't come in for their prescriptions. So I feel that this is very a good system, because people will get the care they need, and it's very impressive that you have a geographic area that you care for, and you're responsible for all of the population within that area. So I'm very impressed. I think that the physicians here and the staff, including the nurses, do a very good job.
Salaam alaikum. What I have noticed about this clinic is that the nurses and the doctors and the people who work here are very involved in their patients. They go to a great deal of trouble to reach out to the patients and to make them feel comfortable. They care about them, and the people here have shown us great generosity, and it's a lovely facility. It's very beautifully decorated, and that, I think that shows that everybody here cares a lot about the job that they do, and they seem very happy.
Thank you. Dr. Kathleen, what's your impression? Also, we will be glad
yes.
to hear
all this. Yes. First of all, I want to thank you all for your very generous hospitality. What a lovely visit we have had here in the center. And I think I will pay you the ultimate compliment, which is that I would be delighted to be a patient here. I have been quite impressed with the extent to which you provide high quality care and a very caring attitude toward your patients. And with chronic disease prevention and management, health education is so important. And I am so pleased to see your strong commitment to providing every staff member in the center provides high quality, comprehensive health education. And that is very lovely to see.
Can I ask another question? Yani, what's your suggestions? What's your advice, if there is any advice in implementing improvement of the service? If you have any ideas, extra ideas, anything, can you supply us with this
So, I think the only thing I can think of, generally everything is of such a high standard that it's difficult to think of something to improve, but I think in the future it might be a good idea to consider electronic health records. And I know that it's very difficult at the beginning to do that, but I think that it would be a good thing to be able to have the information that you have about the patients in a computer and not only on a piece of paper. So that's the only thing I can think of. But it's a very difficult process. It's a very difficult thing, and people will be unhappy for a while, especially the doctors and the nurses. But I think that in the long term, that would be a good thing to do. Mm-hmm. Do you have anything to say?
Just to add to that, I think having information on each patient available electronically allows you to manage a population in a different way. And for instance, it might allow you to get an immediate idea of how the population is doing and whether policies that put in place new priorities make a difference. And I think that the extent to which you can have that sort of information available through an electronic health record may be very valuable. But I do say that things are working now, and it's very hard to disrupt something that's working to try something new. But I think that in the future it's going to be important to have data available, not just to the physician, to the health inspector, to the nurses, but also to researchers, and that there may be a role for research in this sort of setting, because you obviously take very good care of your patients. And I'm very impressed by the teamwork that I see at the health center. Everybody has their role, and everyone works as a full team, and I'm very impressed by that.
Thank you very much.
Another question, if we can. Dr. Sandra, I think.
Catherine,
you visit some areas in Africa about the breastfeeding programs, mm-hmm. as I know. What's your impression about our program here, and what is your advice to for the promotion of that program and the improvement of that program?
So I think that the thing that may be different about Africa and Saudi Arabia is how involved the fathers are with the family and with the young children. And so what I was surprised to see is that there are posters in the men's part of the clinic to promote breastfeeding. So you target not only the women, but you are also targeting the men. So you are looking at the family as a whole unit. And so I think that that is a very important strategy. And the idea of encouraging breastfeeding for 2 years, I think it has health benefits for the mother and it has health benefits for the children. So it seems to be a very good and comprehensive policy.
Great.
This is your impression,
In terms of the promotion of breastfeeding, exclusive breastfeeding, I think it's a very important issue, and it's one that we have been struggling with in the United States for quite some time. And I would say that from what I have seen today, you are making as good an effort, if not better, of an effort here than at home for me in terms of your efforts. I think it is a difficult thing, particularly for women who work outside the home. And I think that is an issue that you probably will want to think about if a fair proportion of your mothers with infant children are working outside the home.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حضر اليوم المركز الصحي الضاحي وفد من جامعة ستانفورد الأمريكية، مرافق له من وفد من دكتور فوزي خليل من جامعة القصيم، وقاموا بجولة مركز الصحي الضاحي وطلعوا على البرامج والأنشطة التي تقام بالمركز. ولله الحمد البرامج هذه كلها كانت مميزة وكذا، وكانوا حضورهم طيب ونال اعجابهم المركز وتقديرهم، وسجلوا اعجابهم في سجل الزيارات من خلال كلمه لموقع صحه القصيم. اقدم خالص شكري لسعاده مدير عام الشؤون الصحيه الدكتور صلاح الخراز ولسعادة مدير سعادة مدير عام الدكتور عبد الله الصيقل على ترشيحهم مركز صحي الضاحي لقيام هذا الوفد بزيارة المركز، وإن شاء الله نكون عند حسن الظن ودائما لهذا الوفد أول وفود القادم إن شاء الله، إن شاء الله وتقديم برامج مميزة وتقديم عمل يخدم صحة المواطن والمقيم. الوفد أمضى حوالي 3 ساعات بالمركز أو أكثر، وكانوا انطباعهم جيد، كان انطباعهم جيد الحمد لله، كان يعني طلع على جميع البرامج، برامج الرضاعة الطبيعية، برامج الفحص المبكر سرطان الثدي، برامج الأمراض المزمنة، التطعيمات، طريقة الكشف على المرضى العاديين، طلعوا على كمان طريق عمل الإدارة، أخذوا انطباع كامل عن الرعاية الصحية الأولية من خلال مركز الصحي الضاحي، فهذا الحمد لله يعتبر إن شاء الله شرف لنا، وإن شاء الله يخدم المنطقة كاملة من خلال تعاون جامعة ستانفورد مع جامعة القصيم بإجراءات بحوث. طبعا الوفد هذا حسب ما فادونا أنهم مركز البحوث الأول بالعالم، وهذا من خلال هذه الزيارة أنه سيقوم ببحث على برامج الرعاية الصحية وبرامج الصحة في المملكة، ولهم زيارات المستشفيات الثانية، فالحمد لله احنا تشرفنا كمركز رعاية صحية، وكرر شكري سعادة المدير العام وسعادة مساعد المدير العام رعاية صحية ولجامعة القصيم بالأخص الدكتور فوزي خليل، وألف شكر لجميع إدارة العلاقات العامة على وجودهم هذا اليوم، وكذلك إدارة الأمن والسلامة على وجودهم وتواجدهم وقت مبكر، والجميع الطاقم الفني والقطاع الصحي سعادة رئيس القطاع الصحي سعادة الرحمن سليمان هريش والأطباء المدراء الفنيين بالقطاع الصحي، وأشكر منسوب العلاقة العامة بصحة القصيم والإعلاميين المتواجدين هذا اليوم، والحمد لله إن شاء الله نكون قدمنا صورة مميزة تعكس الصورة الحقيقية عن الرعاية الصحية بالمملكة العربية السعودية، والف شكر.